My name is Shawn Stevens. I'm a neurotologist practicing in Phoenix, Arizona at Barrow Neurological Institute as part of the new Barrow ENT department. So what makes me choose the Osia system for my patients? So we have a couple different types of patients which I think benefit greatly from this Osia technology. So any patient who has a chronic draining ear or other chronic ear considerations that can't be fit with a hearing aid, they just do terrifically well with this device. Patients with asymmetric or single-sided deafness, sensory neural deafness, do great with this device. And then also, we have a large segment of patients who have existing percutaneous Baha devices that just simply don't want to deal with the hygiene issues anymore and want these converted, and they do very well too. When we talk to and discuss with the families or the patients themselves, you know, who are going to go through the Osia procedure, what to expect. What we're going to be talking about the most is going to be what happens during the surgery and then what happens after the surgery. So the surgery itself, at least in our institution, usually averages about 30 to 35 minutes in length, and that's full operative time from the time they roll in to the time they roll out. The recovery is usually very uneventful, very smooth, and very quick. And the vast majority of these procedures, probably over 90%, are outpatient procedures, meaning they're going to go home the same day, no hospital stay. The recovery that I ask of them after that is going to be take about a week off of work just to rest and recuperate, get lots of extra rest, sleep, hydration, whatever you need, and then be a little bit prepared for some soreness because the area that we do this device, where we do the surgery for the device, is in an area with muscle, and that can sometimes be sore and crampy afterwards. So be prepared for that, but the recovery is usually uneventful. Within a few weeks, we activate the device, and then the hearing journey begins after that. So for other healthcare professionals who are thinking about offering the Osia system, I would really recommend a few things. The first is obviously get educated about the device. Understand what it's able to offer, what the parameters are, and what the benefits of the outcomes can be compared to existing technologies. The second thing I would consider is there's just a wealth of resources out there in terms of watching surgical video content, understanding what the billing and some of the logistical parameters are around these procedures. And then secondarily, what the burden of cost to your clinical team is going to be. So from the time you meet a candidate in clinic, how much work will it take to actually get this patient implanted and fitted? And I think people will be pleased to see that this is very easy, very straightforward and easy to adopt. Of all the things I think that we've been the most impressed with that I would want to like tell other practices, like this is what makes this device special, is the ease from the point of fitting and beyond. So these devices are straightforward, they're user-friendly, our audiologists absolutely love them. They're easy to program, they're easy to fit, and they're very low maintenance and follow-up, meaning we may have one or possibly two visits that patient is excelling in their care immediately with very minimal maintenance follow-up. And there just really isn't anything else like that right now. And so the patients love it, the audiologists love it. I will bring my patients back for a four-month visit for follow-up just to check on them, more for my well-being and peace of mind than theirs. And uniformly, everybody's happy, we're hugging each other. You know, that's the type of hearing health care you want to be able to deliver. Efficient, fast, and effective.